Hi, David. I'm a friend of your father. You can call me Mr. Franklin, okay? Now, I know you may feel a little strange, but it's only because I gave you a particularly strong medicine. Don't you worry about it. We're just going to play a little game I prepared for you. The kids would really like to see you, you know. Oh dear. I have to check on one more thing, so I can focus only on you during our little fun. Now sleep, and remember, don't be afraid.
Oh, I'd never leave you alone. Say hello to your new friend. She'll keep you company.
This is the key ring. It will help you carry all the keys I've hidden. Let the fun begin.
Good, good. But you have to find the key. Yes, yes, very good. A clever boy.
Terrific. What a clever boy. Not so fast. First, you have to free her.
wonderful, David. You are making me so proud.
Thank you.
David, let's take a little break, shall we? I have to confess something. You're not the first child playing at my playground. That's why I want you to know how much fun I had with the other children. We'll go back to our fun only when you listen to this tape.
Now, stand still and listen to this tape. Only then we'll go back to our fun.
What do we have here? Aren't you a little too old for me?
Fuck you!
I wonder if you'd be so lippy when I remove your tongue. Theodore, just take him. I don't have the strength to destroy such a beautiful face. Just kidding. You're in the line just behind Jamie.
Perfect. You're getting closer and closer.
Thank you. Yes! Yes! You've done it! Such a good boy. Interesting. Very interesting. David, my boy, to win the game I prepared for you, you have to follow the numbers. Please find the number one. Thank you. So, you found number one. Bravo. Listen to the tape, David. Oh, Sarah, please don't cry. You have to forgive Uncle Carl. He's just too strong. He just wanted to stroke your little head. look, we're still having fun. Raise your head. I want to introduce you to your sister. Thank you.
Very good. To play with my dearest brother. But remember, he likes to play rough.
Thank you. David woke up and felt hungry. He decided to go to the kitchen to have a little snack. He saw his mother. She didn't turn around, just said,
"David, honey, you can't sleep? Oh, darling, just eat a candy. I left you the whole bowl on your nightstand, as always." "Sweet dreams. Eat the candy and go to bed, honey."
David went to bed and fell into a deep sleep.
David, I can already see that you are a very gifted young man. I think you'll face no problems solving the puzzles I have prepared for you here. If you do well, I'll let you play with my spear.
"It's Andy. I found another kid. A girl. Her name is Lydia. I tried to take her with me, but this psycho already laid his dirty hands on her. I'm warning you. Be careful. Be smart. Play his stupid game so he won't suspect anything. Remember to look for my tapes, though. I'll leave you the screwdriver on the second floor in the drawer of the desk. I have to go. Find my next tape. I'll place crayons on the floor so you can easily find the right desk."
David, is that you? Honey, where are you? We've been looking for you everywhere. Are you alright? Please,
come home as soon as... Did you really fall for that? Oh, just look at your face.
Oh? Why are you leaving so soon? I mean, you can go, but I already miss you so much. Please, come. I have 7 cute fluffy kittens down here. It will be so much fun.
If you're not going to play with me, maybe you'll play with someone else. Oh dear, David. Lydia is in this weird age when she finds boys gross. You know what I mean. But let me tell you the secret. It's the dead boys that she finds the most repelling.
Thank you.
It's Andy. Lydia. The girl I tried to rescue, she's alive, but she's not herself anymore. I've never seen something like this before. This poor girl. I think she doesn't see. When she turned her head in my direction, she didn't react. Listen. I've left the key next to the tape. With the screwdriver, you can open the vent. You can escape through it. The vent is behind the mannequin with a blue hand. Good luck.
Thank you.
la 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 la.
Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep.
La 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 la. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep.
La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
Forest dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep.
David woke up in the late evening and decided to visit his friend, Tom. Tom lived just around the corner, but David always took a shortcut through the backyard. He always sneaked out through the kitchen window. David didn't want to ask his mother for permission. He knew she wouldn't let him go.
Little sounds around the walls, creaks and bumps and scrapes and all. Shadows seem to come alive, bits and pieces left behind. More and more the darkness comes. You and me will have some fun. Screaming, screaming. Now please don't be afraid.
Thank you.
David! Oh, we're having so much fun! You're so obedient and polite. I think you deserve a treat. But before that, I have one more request for you. Would you kindly enter this box? If you do, I might think about letting you go. I just enter the box and maybe you'll be home before the supper. Leave your backpack on the chair, put out the candle, and enter this box. Well done, David. I have to get you all ready for the meeting I've planned. I would be a very selfish man if I didn't share such a treasure like you. It's precious! Can you make that sound one more time? Don't you worry, David. In a little while, it will all be over.
David sneaked out of the house to see his friend. He had to take only a few steps through the rock bridge. Suddenly, he heard a voice.
Excuse me.
The stranger turned his head towards David and said,
"Do you know where house number 7 is?"
David didn't reply and just stared at the man. He couldn't say anything.
"Oh, don't be afraid. I'm the friend of your parents. Maybe we can go together,"
said the man. David wanted to run away, but suddenly someone grabbed him.
I said hello? Come on, don't you want a balloon? Come into the carnival! Thank you.
I'll show you where I play hide and seek.
Oh, you're finally home. I missed you so much. Come, give me a kiss. That wasn't so bad, was it?
That goddamn clown turned off the cameras.
I can't see you, sweetheart.
Once again, he took someone just for himself. Well, good luck. I hope I'll play with what's left of you.
tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tack, tick, tack, tick, tock. You lose. 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 Tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tack. You lose. You lose. Where are you? 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 Where are you?
Are done! You lose.
Hi again, David. I am so sorry it had to come to this. But you have to understand, Theodore. He almost never gets what he wants. And he wanted you so badly. But you're mine. We will play the last game I prepared for you. Oh, I see you're a little roughed up, so take your time. And remember, no cheating. I see that you're drawing your last breaths, but we have to play for the last time.
Come play with me, David.
Just a few more steps and I'll let you rest. Trust me.
You'll have all eternity for resting.
Hello, little brother.
That's the last one, David. I promise.
You won't need that anymore, sweetheart. You've made it, David! Now please put the candle on the cupboard and take a seat. Put the candle over there and sit on the chair.
Oh.
here we are again, David. You and I together at last. I have to tell you that I am very pleased with our game, but it's over now. As you have seen, I have started to clean the house. Some bricks and mortar will do the work. I would never allow anyone to take even a glance at my art. When I'm done with you, I think my work will be finally over. Thank you for that, David. You have really, truly changed me. Now close our eyes and go to sleep. My darling, I just couldn't resist. I'm sorry, you can go to sleep now. Don't be afraid. I'll make sure you have company while you're rotting in the ground.